Happy Wealth Wednesday. Olivia, I'm so glad to have you here representing all of the amazing innovation and communities that are starting to explode across Europe. I think that representation of women on the continent is so powerful and so important. So I can't wait to dive in with you today. I'd love to first have you share a little bit about your background, where you're calling in from, and what you're up to these days.
Yeah, of course. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited. So my name's Olivia. I'm originally from the UK, but I moved to Denmark in 2015. And that's where I've been since then. And I studied my bachelor degree here in marketing management and international trade. And since then, I've really just been working in the world of marketing. And from that, you know, I've always really been into tech. I've always really been into traditional finance growing up as well. And so I really just took that route. And that's landed me into the world of Web3 and blockchain and crypto. And, you know, it's a really exciting space to be in. So, I'm looking forward to it.
First, I'd love to just kick off with the question we ask everyone. I think it's such a great equalizer, which is, what was your first ever investment, whether that was in traditional markets or crypto or both? I'd love to hear what got you started or who.
Yeah, definitely. It's such an interesting question. And I think that, you know, for me, I've always been interested in, especially in traditional finance. I think that from a personal view, I was very fortunate. I have to admit, my dad, you know, he was very open with us as children. And he did teach us the importance of handling your finances and making a budget, paying that budget. What does debt mean? And what's good debt? What's bad debt? You know, credit cards, how does all that work? And including investing. So I would say I've been very fortunate that my dad taught me those things at a young age. In terms of my personal first investment, I was actually 14 years old. At the time, unfortunately, at the time when I was 14, my grandfather passed away. But of course, this meant that all of the grandchildren received a small inheritance from that. And I knew at 14 years old, I knew, you know, I don't want to go out and spend this, and I don't want to let it sit in a bank account because it's just going to lose money, essentially. So what I did was I opened something called a junior ISA, which is something that we have in the UK. And this is a junior ISA for stocks and shares. So anybody under 18 can open this account. You can invest your money into that account and you won't pay tax or any capital on any capital growth or dividends that you receive from that. So it's a really great incentive for young people, especially in the UK, to get started with investing. So I put it there. I let it sit there until I was 21. And I said, you know, I don't want to use this until I want to use it on something special. And then I used it when I was 21 to travel the United States, actually. So I went through 18 states.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah. So it was special and it meant a lot as well, you know. So, I would definitely say to anybody there, you know, if you're in the UK, there's a lot of different types of ISAs that you can get, and definitely look into something for your children as well.
Beautiful. It's so special how there are differences across different geographies and how to get started. So it's a great tip. And I know one of the big issues a lot of people typically have here in the US is they'll deposit into it an account, but it'll sit in a money market fund. So even though they've made a deposit into the account, it's not actually invested into the market. Is that the case with these specific accounts as well? Or is it kind of like an index fund?
I mean, I have to say there are different types of ISAs. There's not just one type of ISA. I believe there's up to 8 different types of ISAs accounts in the UK that you can choose. Of course, you can just choose a traditional long-term savings account, and that is just purely tax-free savings for children. You can also open that as an adult as well in the UK. But as mentioned, you can also open stocks and shares ISAs. And that is where the money will be invested, but you won't pay tax on any capital growth or dividends that you make on that investment.
Very cool. But they sort of pre-select which stocks that you get exposed to. Yeah. In the accounts. Got it. Yeah. So you didn't have to choose. You just had to open the account. Yeah. And then it was done for you. Wow, that's so special. Yeah. And how about crypto? What got you into the world of crypto? Because you do spend like most of your day job there now as well, and then also educating women on the topic.
Yeah. So I've always been interested in traditional finance. You know, I had some investments on the stock market personally, and obviously through junior ISAs when I was younger in the UK. And, you know, as I grew up now and crypto is getting very popular, it's gaining traction, you know, I have a lot of friends that are starting to mention it. And I really just thought, you know, I don't know too much about it, but I would like to know about it. And so I'm going to find out. And so I really just went searching, you know, job hunting for marketing positions in Web3, blockchain and crypto. The women in Web3, it actually stemmed from that, you know, my previous experience personally with traditional investing, traditional finance. There's a massive difference in the amount of male investors compared to female investors. And then I kind of transitioned into crypto and I was seeing the same thing again, if not, you know, even slightly a bigger gap, a gender gap there. And that's really what pushed me. I just thought, you know, we talk enough about the gender gap in traditional finance and the gender gap in payments, wage payments. And then you're moving into this new industry and we're making the same mistakes again. And I was, it has to change. So that was really what gave me the motivation to start Crypto Dames and really try to get this education for women, free education for women into the space of Web3 and blockchain.
It's fantastic. I think that leads perfectly into how do you see your role now in the wealth space and why is that important?
I think that I would like to see my role as an inspiration to women everywhere who want to get started and they might not necessarily know how to get started because we know in this market, we know even in the way it's marketed that crypto and blockchain is marketed towards a male audience. That's why you see crypto.com and FTX sponsoring the Formula One, because it's got this mass male audience and they're just, you know, picking it up. They're getting exposed to it on another level that women, as of yet, I don't believe are being exposed to the same standard. And so it really is just, I hope that I can be a source of inspiration that look, we might not be there yet in society, but there's nothing stopping us. And the other thing is really, I really hope that, you know, I can motivate others around as well to break down the barriers to entry. Even in Europe, there's a 13% pay gap between a male and a woman in the same, exact same position, exact same age, exact same educational background. There's a 13% difference where a woman is paid 13% less on average. And it's got to stop. We've already got so many barriers, so let's not create more in this new industry, which ironically is supposed to be community driven, a consensus mechanism. It's meant to be by the people for the people.
I'm really inspired by your story of seeing and exploring so many of these communities in the United States and North America, and then realizing just how important it was to have some voices and inspiration across Europe and, you know, especially within Denmark and places that are very close to your community and how important that is. I'd love to hear sort of in that process of exploring the differences and similarities, both in like marketing and community, what do you think is the most exciting thing you've learned that you would want others to know?
The most exciting thing that I would love others to know is that there is so much potential in blockchain technology. And I think that blockchain technology and crypto in general, from an outside view, can sometimes unfortunately be put into a box of, oh, it's a money-making scheme, or oh, it's a scam. And that's what I hear the most, especially when I'm speaking with the ladies in the group. You know, some of them feel very unsure. They're like, oh, well, I've heard that this happens and I've heard that this happens. You know, is that true? And I just want to say, yes, crypto is a digital currency, but the technology it's built on, the blockchain technology itself, can be used in so many different ways, so many different ways, and ways that we haven't actually even discovered yet. But they're going to come. And that's what is the most exciting thing, I think, is the potential of the blockchain technology and what that could do for society in the future.
I love that. Is there any particular like use case or even company that you've seen that's really inspiring you in the space, especially in terms of like real world use case? I know it's pretty early, but I'm just curious if there's anything that's really inspiring you and why.
Yeah, I mean, of course, again, it's early days, you know, we're still, especially in the EU here, we're going through a lot of regulation talks at the moment. We can't say for sure where those regulations will end up. We have an idea, but we can't be sure. But I would definitely say, you know, we already know some of the potential for blockchain technology, for example, with smart contracts. We know that it is possible to sell your house, your physical real house, and sell it via smart contract. And you can actually do, real estate contract sales and buying through blockchain technology. And I think that the other thing is as well, we have to remember that, again, blockchain technology, it's just another level of security that, you know, that form of security could be implemented in so many different ways. And also the fact that, you know, you have more control over your data. And I think that data control, data ownership, even just being able to track where is my data being handled, they're all, you know, going to be more and more important as we go on. And I think that blockchain technology could alleviate some of the issues that we see in those areas.
I definitely agree. Just the sheer amount of like simplicity that blockchain has unlocked ownership, you know, that, you know, one of the core tenets is ownership. That's why we have tokens and cryptocurrencies. People are owning the infrastructure. And this idea of, you know, removing the third party intermediary. So that real estate example is such a great example of both of those things, you know, owning the contracts, you know, deeds and information of your house, and not needing, you know, a third party broker for you to execute the transaction and exchange of that deed or that ownership to another party and to have it tracked in an immutable record. It's a really great example. Yeah. And what advice would you give to somebody getting started?
I would definitely say, and this is something that actually we touched upon in the Wealth Summit, and I think it's one of those things that when you first come into the space, if you're completely new to blockchain, crypto, Web3, it can at times feel really overwhelming. So you might read something or learn something and you just look at it and you think, I'm never going to get this. I'm never going to understand tokenomics or whatever it might be. And you can look at that page and just think, that's it, I give up, I'm never going to get there. But I think the thing is just to remember, Rome wasn't built in a day. And no matter how overwhelming you feel at the moment in the time, I think it's important not to, you know, brush it aside and say, okay, that's it, I can't do it. You know, give yourself the time. It's okay, you're going to get past it. Take a break, take a breather, whatever you need. And come back to it when you're ready. Because I really find that just taking a break when it can be overwhelming and there's so much information and crypto and blockchain really is a rabbit hole. You know, you could go as far down as you want and you'll never hit the bottom almost. And it's just, you know, take that breathing space and then come back to it with a refreshed mind and you will get through it and you will succeed.
It's such good advice. I feel like one, repeat exposure helps a lot, right? The more you see a term or different examples applied to something like NFTs or smart contract, it just starts to become part of something that you know, which is common to sort of anything, you know, practice or repeat exposure can be such a big part of it. But I also love what you're sharing. Like, I mean, you and I spend so much time in the space. It's what we do all day long. And it still feels like an infinite rabbit hole of things to learn. So, you know, having a focused industry or something that you care about can be really motivating. And then more than anything, what I loved about the summit and, you know, some of these things is just like finding your friends. You know, I was reading a recent post, which was like, share this with your crypto moon circle. And I kind of laughed because I was like, that's so, it's, you know, kind of cheesy and witchy and funny, but it's also it adds that levity of like, this doesn't have to be serious. It can be something that you can just, you know, chat about with your girls group chat or whatever, just so it feels more fun to explore and learn. Yeah, I really love that. And that's why Crypto Danes and Eve and all these spaces need to exist, so you can find your group of people that you resonate with.
Yeah. And that's why I said, you know, hats off to Denise. It was amazing to get to speak with her and meet her at the Wealth Summit, because I started off in Surge, you know, and there was Surge, I think Crypto Besties, She256, fantastic US-based communities. But they're huge. It's amazing. And I love it. And I just saw this and there was so much inspiration and everybody there was so helpful. You know, even when I was starting off in there, I think, you know, I must have asked a couple of questions in those communities and I would just get replies from it. And I think that sense of community, it's so helpful and it really creates a stable base for you to lean on and get support when you need it. And also remember, don't be afraid to ask a question. Don't be afraid if you don't understand something. There's absolutely nothing wrong with saying, hey, you know what? I don't understand this, but I'd really like to. Can somebody help? Because there will always be somebody to help you.
I couldn't agree more. And I'm really excited about what you're up to with Crypto Danes. I see a lot of similarities with hyper successful, more traditional finance groups like Female Invest. They're also Danish. So yeah. I just can't wait to see what you create and how that grows. And I'd love to share, how can we stay in touch with you personally and also Crypto Danes as you expand and grow and evolve what you're up to?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, always welcome to reach out to me on LinkedIn. If you just search my name, or I can also share the link as well, you know, reach out, connect with me, send me a message. I love to hear from you. And we also do have a Discord server as well for Crypto Danes. As mentioned, a lot of us are based in the EU, in the Nordic countries, you know, Denmark, Sweden, and Norway and Finland. But of course, again, anybody is welcome in the group. So please join in. And also, I would like to say as well, if there's any businesses out there who know actively, we would love to make a difference for the female community who want to get into Web3 and blockchain and crypto and learn more. I would definitely say, please get in contact. Please reach out to me, because I would love to set up some educational time for the girls and the ladies in the group. And if you know that your company could help with that education, reach out and let's talk about it.
Fantastic. Well, we will definitely be following along. Thank you so much for being part of this today and for doing all the amazing work that you're doing. It's such a pleasure to know you.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.